sheet, okay? Don't do anything with it yet, okay? Do you guys know what this is?
Yeah.
A Venn diagram, good job, okay? So, just hang on to it for right now, okay? And we'll get to it in just a second. The two of you, oh, there's three. Called Old Yeller, is that correct?
Yeah.
All right, what can you guys tell me about your story? Give me some details, something about your characters, maybe the setting where the story takes place. Besides Old Yeller?
They're Arnis.
And Arnis is? See, the younger brother?
Who is he? He's the younger brother.
Younger brother, okay. Who else is there?
Travis is the older brother.
Okay, Travis is the older brother. Is there a parent in the story?
Yeah, but I don't know his name.
Is it just his mom? That's okay. All right, so. So we have Old Yeller who saves the youngest boy from messing with a bear, correct? Okay, and Old Yeller saves the day. Okay, do they live on a farm? Where do they live? On a farm? Who's on a farm? Okay. Okay, in a cabin?
I think it's like
Okay.
Something.
Okay, so what we're going to do, okay, is I am now going to read you a story, okay, with the Venn diagram. What do you think we're going to do with the two stories? What do you think?
We'll put one on one side and the story characters are going to read on the other, and we'll compare and contrast.
Compare and contrast. Good job. Okay. So what we're going to do is I want you guys to first put your name on your paper. Make sure everybody gets your name on the paper. And then we're going to turn the paper over on the back. Marched until he saw a great rock. It was a good place to stop and rest. rest. Kip reached in his bag for a woolly rhino rib, still sweet and smoky from his fire. Suddenly, up popped a paleo wolf, looking for leftovers. Wolf's nose began to twitch and sniff. He sniffed to the left. He sniffed to the right. What are you doing? Teased Kip. What can you smell in this emptiness? Paley Wolf held his snout high in the air. With his keen nose, he could smell a rain cloud across the valley, the track of a tiny toad, the pelt of a prying pachyderm. But most of all, he could smell roasted woolly rhino bones, and he gave a hungry whine. Pooh, said Kip, I can't smell anything but my dinner, and it's all for me. And he turned his back on the wolf. Hey. One thing that's good about Jambrett, have you guys read a story by Jambrett before?
No,
like the mitten, you heard of that one?
Yes.
Okay,
yeah.
You see how she does all these illustrations out here?
Yeah.
She gives clues as to what's coming next. So, if we look at the page, okay, and our drawings out here, what could possibly be coming next?
Mammoth.
A mammoth, maybe, we'll see. But Paleywolf had already hurried away. And when Kip saw the reason why, he was just able to get away in time. Were you right in your guess? Are you guys seeing some differences already? Are we seeing some similarities, things that are the same between the two stories yet? Soon, Kip was back on the homeward trail. He walked on and on until he spied a cave. It was a fine place to stop and rest. He thought about another rhino rib, still crackly and crunchy from the fire. Up popped Paleo Wolf, looking for leftovers. Wolf's ears began to turn and dip. He listened to the left, and he listened to the right. What are you doing? Mocked Kip, taking a big bite. What can you hear in this silence? Wolf cocked his head. With his fine canine ears, he could hear a fish rise in the water, a leaf fall, the soft pant, pant, pant of a cave bear. But most of all, he could hear the snap of a woolly rhino bone still crisp in the fire, and he gave a pleading howl. Pooh, said Kip, I can't hear anything except my teeth crunching on these very tasty bones. And he threw a clump of moss at Paleo Wolf. Hey, do you see the clues?
Mm-hmm.
What might be coming?
Fish.
What do you think?
A bear.
Let's see if you're right.
Fish.
But Paleo Wolf had already hurried away, and when Kip saw the reason why, was just able to get away in time. Did you guys find something the same? Soon, Kip was back on the homeward trail, more foot sore and weary than ever. He trudged on and on until he saw a big tree. It was just the place to stop and rest. He climbed the tree and reached for a woolly rhino rib, still pearly and greasy from the fire. Up popped Paleo Wolf looking for leftovers. Wolf's eyes began to sparkle and dance. He looked to the left, and he looked to the right. What are you doing? Jeered Kip. What can you see in this darkness? Wolf's eyes glowed. With his sharp eyes, he could see the shimmer of the distant dewdrop, a mouse scurrying far away, a feline sleeping high above. But most of all, he could see a pearly, greasy morsel of rhino bone shining in the moonlight. Pooh, said Kip. I can't see anything except, of course, my roasted, toasted, crispy, crunchy, pearly, greasy, woolly rhino rib. And you won't be tasting that because I want it all to myself. Then Kip yelled, shoo, as loud as he could. The yell resounded up and down the tree. It woke every living thing around. Instantly, Paley Wolf's nose wrinkled and his ears went back. His eyes narrowed and his tail stood out. He looked so terrible that Kip threw the whole bag of rhino ribs down from the tree. Help yourself, Wooly! But Paley Wolf did not care about dinner now. His mane bristled and ridged on his back. A long growl shook from his throat. It was his last warning. Kip opened his eyes very wide. He looked all around, but he could not smell or hear. Gone. Kip. I must disappear too. And he shrank into the leafy branches and made himself very small. Just in time, for high in the tree was the most fearsome of creatures, the saber-toothed cat. She crouched, she snarled, and then she sprang. She hurled past Kip, hidden in the leaves, and pounced on a pile of woolly rhino bones down below. All that night, he sat in the tree. Kip thought and thought. He shivered over Paleo's last warning. It had not been 1 second too soon. The next morning, Kip climbed down. There was Paleo looking for leftovers. Together, they looked at the spot where the bones had been, and they were very gloomy. Finally, Kip made a speech. He said, "Wolfie, if you use your keen nose and your fine ears and your sharp eyes to keep me from being eaten up, I promise to share with you all the woolly rhino ribs and even mammoth meat that I cook over my fire." Paleo barked, meaning yes, and then he wagged his tail, the very first wolf to do so. When Kip saw that, he cried, "And I will call you dog," which means one who wags his tail. Then Kip the cave boy and the first dog went on home.
Was this during the Ice Age?
Not the Ice Age, because it's not ice, but it's the same, there's the same animals and stuff in that time period. Because the Ice Age was when everything was covered in ice. Stories.
Yes.
Okay, so what we're going to do, okay, is I'm going to draw our Venn diagram up here. Okay, and you guys are going to help me fill this out. Alright, so our first story is called Old Yeller, correct? What's our second story?
The first dog.
Good job. You guys were listening. Okay. Who can tell me one thing that is the same with the characters? Something the same with the characters. Can I use your sticks to call names? Names. Carter.
They both have a dog.
Okay, is it a dog? Okay, but he acts like a dog, correct?
Yeah.
Okay, so we'll put the idea of a dog. We're going to do that here. Sophie, what can you tell me about the characters? Can it be the same or different? Animals. characters. Okay, the different incidents that happened to the characters, the things that they got themselves into. Can you guys tell me one thing that is different, Madeline? You to now write one more difference here, one more difference here, and one more thing that they're the same without my help. Do it on your own, okay? On your own, find one thing that was different for each story and one thing that they have in common. Don't tell me, write it down on your paper.
I forgot one of them. It was a rhinoceros or a...
it was the mammoth. You think about the mammoth. Okay, try to think of another one. If we already covered ones you wrote down in the back, try to think of another. There are plenty of differences in the stories. Some things you can think about are the ages of the boys, maybe what they were wearing, where the story takes place, where they lived. Thank you. put a star, okay, next to the one that you write yourself, so that tells me which ones you came up with by yourself. Just put it right at the beginning to make a nice star for me.
I highlight the first word of it. I put the only right.
That's fine.
Just so that I know that those are the ones you came up with by yourself. Person all the way at the front of the room. Turn around, reach behind you, get the paper from behind you for them. I'll come back and pick them up. So, do you guys know what a Venn diagram is? Like what it's called? The type of tool it is. What do you think?
It helps you compare things.
It does help us compare and contrast things.
It helps us figure out what's the same and what's the difference between them.
Good. What's the same and what's different? Okay. Good.
It helps us learn about the book.
Okay. We're talking about character settings, parts of the story.
It helps us with the differences.
Mm-hmm. Differences and similarities. What else?
Are we doing what it does or like what it is?
How can it help you?
Either
one's fine.
Just in the leading things and the differences.
Okay. Good. Do you guys know that this is called a graphic organizer?
Yeah.
You have heard that word before.
I was gonna say.
What do we use graphic organizers for?
To sort stuff out.
To sort stuff out. To maybe help us write what? What can we use a graphic organizer to help us write? Stories. Okay, good. What else?
Letters.
Letters. If you wanted, yeah, if you wanted to write out, make sure you got certain points in your letter. You guys done? You still working? Done? You write a paragraph or something over this, you could do it, right?
Yeah.
And know how they're different, how they're the same? Okay?
Yeah.
Very good. Do you see how easy these are? It's pretty simple to fill this out, right?
Yeah.
So you think it'd be simple to fill one of these out and write a paper? We do. We want to write a letter to somebody.
Yeah.
Maybe make sure that we get things in our paper. It's going to help us write all that out, right?
Mm-hmm.
Very good. Okay. I'm going to draw four people, okay, because I have a game that goes along with this. So, those four people are going to come and help me play the game. Okay. Thank you. Brendan. Okay, I hope you guys are paying attention to the story. These questions have to do with our story. Justin. Two boys, oh my goodness. Matt. you guys are gonna come with me and we're gonna go play our game out in the hallway.
Alright.
Are you guys paying attention?
Yeah.
Alright, I hope so. We'll see who can win. Okay?